Hi again.
All right, welcome. Is there anything you wanted to say or let the viewers know before we get started?
Well, something I just found out is that we all have the same amount of hours in the day as Beyonce. Like, five, can you comprehend six, seven, that? Eight. Dance with me in my backyard, boy. Looking super fine in your corduroy. Drive me around the block, we can go in a loop. That's insane, right?
So did you want to say anything or promote anything before we get started here?
Oh, subscribe to my OnlyFans. It's onlyfans.com/.
Oh, no, sorry. You can't say that here. This is a family channel.
Why am I here then?
I like cash in my hair to my ass. Do the dash, can you make it go fast? Fuck the fame, all I want is them bands. If she keep on mugging, I'ma steal her man. He watching my behavior cause he know
I'm leaving. I ate this book up because it was just so easy to fall in love with the characters, and I am such a sucker for a good love story. Like when Edward watches Bella sleep because he's just so infatuated with her. My heart is so sweet. Y'all, he watched her sleep. Like, he was literally in the corner of her room looking at her like, I also just really love Bella Swan. I got so immersed in her character and I felt like I could put myself in her shoes. Bella is probably the most annoying character I've ever read about in my life because this girl has nothing. She has no goals, no ambitions, no hopes, no dreams, no breath. Like, okay, ask me what I want to drink.
Okay. What do you want to drink, Bella?
Well, I guess I'll just have some water. But honestly, the thing that takes the cake in this book for me is their love story. Bella and Edward just have such a beautiful, beautiful love story. And honestly, Team Edward all the way. I'm team somebody get Bella a backbone because she just doesn't have one. Her life literally revolves around all the men in the story to the point where her dad would actually starve if Bella wasn't there to cook for him. This book, basura. So I mean this in the nicest way possible, but Katniss is kind of annoying. Katniss is my mom and she is the heroine. It's like, I know she's the main character and we gotta find out a lot about her, but it seems like she's the only one we learn anything about. I literally could not tell you anything else about any of the other characters. Legit, all I know about PETA is like, bread. Heroine? Heroine. Hero? Heroine? Hero? Katniss is my mom and she's the hero that we all need. I'm just not the biggest fan because it honestly felt a little violent at times. There was a lot of like killing and dying and that's just not my kind of thing. More competition, more violence, more fighting, more killing, more dying, more death! City of Bones honestly has a lot of problems with it, not even to mention the fact of all the allegations going around about Cassandra Clare possibly plagiarizing it. I love the Shadowhunters and I love everything that Cassandra Clare did with this novel all by herself. But honestly, we all know who takes the cake. It's Jace. He can take all the cakes in the world. He's just so witty and sarcastic and hot.
Sarah?
And then let's talk about Jace because honestly, he's not even witty. He's just arrogant and he's narcissistic. And then everybody's just like, oh my God, Jace, say something arrogant to me. But Cassandra Clare just covers it up with the fact that like, oh, but he's like smoking hot. See, I say all that, but at the same time, if you're watching this, Jace, call me. John Green's out here looking for Alaska, but maybe once he finds Alaska, he can tell her to write a better book. Boom, roasted. He's always killing it with the quotes and the characters, and they're always just so fun, especially Alaska. Actually, no, Alaska probably wouldn't even be able to write a better book because she is the worst Like, she's actually the worst. Alaska is just such an amazing character, and honestly, I see why everyone loves her, because I fell in love with her too. Can someone tell me why everyone and their mothers were so in love with her? Like, when Alaska says, "Y'all smoke to have fun, but I smoke to die," I wanted to get that tattooed on me. ASAP. Want to get it tattooed on me, I need to get it tattooed on me, and I will get that quote tattooed on me because it's just so beautiful. Dude, when she says, "Y'all smoke to have fun, but I smoke to die," I wanted to die too. My brain just, it malfunctioned. I could not believe I was reading such monstrosities in this book. I just feel like if there's anything John Green knows how to write, it's definitely teenagers, because I just connected with every single one of them. And I just related so much to all their struggles and how they always felt and all their like teen angst. Their personalities literally just consisted of smoking and drinking, because all teens do that, right? And just being quirky and like wacky little cool, you know, talking about like famous last word type teens. And I honestly don't know why I was surprised, because that's literally how every single one of John Green's characters are. So that's gonna be it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. You better have enjoyed it. Thank you so much for listening to my opinions on these books as opposed to hers. If you like this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up, and we'll see you probably meshed together as one in the next video. Bye. Bye.
I like cash in my hair to my ass. Do the dash, can you make it go fast? Fuck the fame, all I want is them bands. If she keep on mugging, I'ma steal her man. He watching my behavior, 'cause he know.